I want to take you back in time. This is a week ago today, 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Matthew wasn't even Matthew yet. It was just a tropical depression. But by this point, I was going, this is one to watch. This is where the big ones are born. And it was indeed. It became a Category 5 storm. After being a Category 1 hurricane, it developed very, very rapidly into a Category 5. Now, this box doesn't match it quite as well as it should. It hit 160 miles an hour on last Saturday. So again, Friday and Saturday. So again, a huge, huge storm, and it was a strong Category 4 as it moved through Haiti and just obviously devastated that country, and moved through Cuba, and then moved on up toward the U.S. after it moved through the Bahamas and had 120 mile an hour winds by last Friday. Now, the thing about it was, early in the week, we were going, watch out, this could hit us. And then once we got to about Wednesday and Thursday, it looked like it would loop around south of Charleston and then loop back around toward Florida and not get us, really. It would affect us with a little bit of rain. So our guard came down a little bit. And it was, again, the Hurricane Center forecast had it right around like that. Well, it moved northward toward Charleston and was expected to curve eastward and on out to sea. But it zigged when it should have zagged, and then it moved on up toward the Myrtle Beach area as a Category 1 storm. And it was expected to move eastward again as it moved toward the Wilmington area after it moved through Myrtle Beach. And this is Saturday evening at 8, after it was already a lot closer than we expected for it to be to our area. Well, it moved north-northeastward toward Hatteras and moved directly just past Hatteras during the late night hours, and then finally started that east-northeastward trek and on out to sea before it fell apart during the early morning hours of Monday. So again, here's 5 o'clock Saturday into Sunday at 2 o'clock. You see finally our rainfall ending by around 10, 11 o'clock in the morning for the most part through the area. But there you can see the eye of the storm moving right on Cape Hatteras and then on out to sea. We'll let it play one more time, and you can see the eye right there moving, just brushing Cape Hatteras, and there's where it is. Let's see if we can locate it right on into there as of Sunday afternoon. Now, one other thing that went on with this is that we ended up with a lot of rainfall, obviously, through the area, 8 to 12 inches of rainfall through the area. Now, I'm drawing this line because this was a front that set up with an east-southeasterly wind flow on one side of it, and then more of a northerly wind on the other side of it. Well, that northerly wind hitting that southeasterly wind caused air to rise. It was air mass clashing together. It rose. It was tropical air. We ended up with tropical downpours, especially these little waves of rainfall that weren't that bad into most of North Carolina, but they hit the Hampton Roads area and just blossomed right on in, especially over the south side and southwestward toward Gates County and Hertford County. So again, we had a huge rainfall out of that particular situation. Well, it's now all the way on up to the Canadian Maritime Provinces. There's Nicole. Nicole's not going to bother us. So again, we're looking pretty good. Okay, let's get to it. Have a look at our great weather ahead as we move right on in over the top of us. You saw that northerly wind, clouds generated by a few northerly wind, but those clouds from that are even gone. But we've still got a breeze out there near the shoreline during the overnight hours. But anywhere inland, 44, 45, 48, and then it'll be around 55, 58, a little bit closer to the water's edge. So chilly overnight. This is going to be an autumn chill during the overnight hours. And during the day tomorrow, we'll recover as far as temperatures around 68, 70 degrees, a little bit of cloud cover in the afternoon. As the things are, 7 o'clock in the evening, not as cold by Wednesday morning. Still that northerly wind or north-northeasterly, 52, 56, then low 60s close to the coastline on Wednesday morning. And then during the afternoon, around 70, 73, stray showers possible, but not real, real likely for the day on Wednesday. Overnight, that's our big thing. Clear a little bit on the chilly side, 46, 48, 52, then mid to upper 50s along the water's edge, with that breeze stronger near the water, 10 to 20 near the water, and around 10 miles an hour inland. Here's where things are for the south side, 46 to around 52 degrees for the peninsula, 46, 47 up to about 52 near the water's edge. And we move to the middle peninsula, the northern neck, the eastern shore. Temperatures feel like fall overnight, with mid to upper 40s and then low 50s over the eastern shore. Chilly overnight, little warmer tomorrow, a little warmer than that by Wednesday, and we'll likely cool off a bit by Thursday night into Friday. Temperatures mostly in the upper 60s and low 70s.